Hey, what's going on, CoinApp TV subscribers? Robert Walkney here with special guest Andrew Renee, popular TV host and producer and good friend of mine. And we're going to do some of these CoinApp TV Skype chatter videos. And in this video, we want to talk about the Game Awards, in which she was there in attendance with a lot of other friends of mine. So, Andrea, good evening, good afternoon, and happy holidays to you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me on. I know we haven't done anything on camera together in quite some time.
I'm very sad because I miss you tons. We used to hang out a lot more, and now I'll only see you at events and stuff. And but I'm glad we can Skype. So the Game Awards. Let's preface this by saying I personally am a big fan of Jeff Keighley, what he does with the industry. I know Andrea has worked with him and done some things before, and I'm sure she sort of supports him. So we get that out of the way. That we love Jeff and whatever he does. But we want to be objective, and we want to talk about the Game Awards. It's the first time we had this. It's sort of a carryover from the VGAs. Am I explaining that well? Am I prefacing that well?
No, this is a 100% original show created by Jeff. It has no affiliation with the Video Game Awards, VGX, or Spike. The only connection is that Jeff worked both for Spike and now has started his own award show, but this is completely independent. He did this all on his own.
Okay.
Well, I mean, he had a team helping him, but, like, he did not work with Spike or with any people at Viacom to produce this.
Okay, so brand new thing, brand new location, Las Vegas, or mm-hmm. First time for everything. So you were there. Can you talk about the venue, the setup, the look of things?
Yeah, so it was held at the Access Theater in Planet Hollywood on the Las Vegas Strip. The theater is great. It's actually the same theater that Britney Spears performs her Vegas show in, and I had the amazing opportunity to go see that show earlier this year. Fantastic. So the theater is, like, legit. I believe it holds, like, 4,000 people. It wasn't quite full for the first Game Awards. I think a lot of people just didn't know what it was going to be, which was maybe why it didn't sell out. Hopefully it will sell out next year. I thought the show looked fantastic. The production value was amazing. There were some really fantastic performances. I mean, it opened with, Koji Kondo on stage playing the Mario theme. I mean, it was amazing. I had a great time.
Yeah, it was very entertaining. I was in LA watching it live streamed online, and let's talk about some of the presenters and the people sort of involved. Did you think it had a good mixture of well-known people and maybe some newcomers or indie people?
Yeah, I would definitely say it did. I thought it was really nice that they got iJustine and Boogie up there to present the trending award for, the gaming personality. I thought that was really great to get people who are really deeply involved in the online gaming community to present that award. And then we also saw, A-list celebrities. Kiefer Sutherland was there to talk about Metal Gear Online with Hideo Kojima. That was a really big get. And then for Best Performance, all of the voice actors who were nominated were there, and Trey Parker was there to accept his award. So, I mean, I thought that it was a really nice mix of, like, traditional, like, what you would consider, like, A-list Hollywood talent, and then the actual, like, boots on the ground developers, people who are making the games, and then the people who are talking about the games as well, internet personalities and such. It was nice. It was a nice crowd. And then for once, there was actual real gamers that were there in the front row cheering on the performances on stage. Anyone who's watched the VGAs knows that previous years, it's just seat fillers. Like, these are just Hollywood actors who are collecting a paycheck and who probably could, care less about the video game awards. So I'm really glad that, they got actual gamers, at the show. It was cool.
Yeah, definitely had a feel. We throw around that for gamers, by gamers and stuff, but Jeff seems to got a umbrella, from top to bottom with, the gaming industry. So that was really great. In a second, we're going to talk about, we'll jump to, like, the Game of the Year choices and what you may or not have played and what you thought of the outcome. But I just want to talk a little bit more about the show in general and maybe some highlights. Was there something that was, like, the oh my gosh moment or, like, I can't believe this or anything like that?
I think it's hard to pinpoint, one particular thing. I did really like the moment where Koji Kondo performed with Imagine Dragons on stage when they performed the music together. That was really kind of special. Also, seeing the new footage from No Man's Sky seemed to get a lot of people hyped. I made a joke about it on Twitter that I still really don't care about that game, because what is that game?
Right.
You know, I had previously mentioned they also debuted Metal Gear Online, and we got to see some other trailers for some things as well. It's hard for me to remember exactly what happened on stage at the Game Awards and what happened on stage at the PlayStation Experience keynote, because they were back-to-back. But the awards overall were just, I thought they were really well done. I thought that they went a little long. I think that there was certain segments he probably could have cut. I did really appreciate that Jeff didn't try to do any stupid gimmicky things at the award show. Like, we've seen previous hosts and presenters at the VGAs do these dumb skits. Do you remember the year that Felicia Day, and I love Felicia, she is one of the sweetest people and she's super talented, but she was doing those dumb skits like backstage at the VGAs, and there was one where she was like climbing a Velcro wall or something. Like, things just didn't make sense. And like the stupid stuff that they had Samuel L. Jackson doing, you know, in previous years, I'm glad that they cut all of that garbage out and really just focused on the performances and the personalities and the awards. He could have given out more awards and focused more on the awards, which was still a big criticism of this show. I think it's a tough balance for any producer to think about what can I do that's entertaining but also honors the awards themselves, because not every award is interesting to the audience, but it's all obviously important to the developers and to the people who actually make the games. So I thought it was a nice balance. Hopefully he'll trim it down a little bit next year. I had to take quite a few cocktail breaks.
Yeah, there was like the message saying like, you've enjoyed the first half of the show, now wait for the second half, and people on Twitter were just like, what? There's still like an hour and a half left to go, so like a 3-hour show is definitely has some fat to trim. And then watching it at home, so you were there, so I watched it at home. There was no commercials. Every commercial was a trailer or a premiere or something we hadn't seen before, so it was hard for me to take my little pee breaks, because I was like, oh, wait, is this a reveal? I got to stick around. So that even kind of compounded things, you know, more. So In a way, I want that MMA trailer just so I know I can, you know, get out for 2 minutes and go to the bathroom. So cool. Well, let's not talk about the award show, just Singularity. We want to talk about the games and what was presented. You know, we got, let me call up my list on my iPhone here. So Game of the Year, we'll jump straight to Game of the Year nominees. Bayonetta 2, Nintendo exclusive, Dark Souls 2, Dragon Age Inquisition, Hearthstone, Blizzard, and Shadow of Mordor, Middle-Earth Shadow of Mordor. Have you played any of these?
I've played pretty much all of them except for Dark Souls 2. I played it at a demo event one time. I can't count that as actually playing the game. But I stayed away from it just particularly because that type of gameplay doesn't excite me as a gamer. And as people who work in video games press, there's so many things to play. We just can't possibly get to anything. So, and I didn't vote on the Game of the Year award, so don't worry, audience. I didn't play, but I also didn't vote. But I thought Dragon Age was completely deserving of winning the award. I mean, my personal pick was Middle-Earth Shadow of Mordor. That's my personal Game of the Year, because I thought that they did some really innovative things with the Nemesis system, but Dragon Age is an amazing game. Completely deserve it. The team did a fantastic job, and I'm excited to sink some more hours into it over the holiday break.
Yeah, it's I'm pretty close to you. For me, Shadow Mordor was best game, but I am playing Dragon Age Inquisition more, and it feels like a bigger game. So you know, there's more going on or longer. So maybe I'm leaning a little more towards Inquisition. Haven't played Bayonetta 2, and Hearthstone I've played some of. A little bit of surprise for that Game of the Year. Did you think there was something maybe missing, you know, a dark horse that you would add to that, or maybe swap something out?
I think a lot of people felt slighted that Super Smash Bros. For Wii U wasn't on that list, because it was one of the best score games of the year. But I think that Smash is in a tough position because people want to score that game high not only because it was really solidly built, but also because of that, like, long-time love affair that we all have with Nintendo as gamers. If you've been gaming for more than 10 years, then you grew up with Nintendo games, you know? And I think that that association is hard to sometimes separate from your actual valid opinion of the game, because there was a lot of, you know, really well-done games that came out this year. Also, Mario Kart 8. Really well done game, but I think it suffers from that same problem that Super Smash did. There were some other games that maybe could have been considered for Game of the Year, but were maybe too indie, you know, to be considered. And it's tough when you talk about what are the qualifiers for Game of the Year, like where do you make the check boxes, right? Like, it has to have this and this and this and this to qualify. Like, I don't know what those things are. Do you have a Game of the Year that wasn't on that list?
It's tough because, no offense to the game industry, but 2014 to me was a bit of a bust. You know, a lot of games come out sort of incomplete, not working, needing patches. You know, some games that you and I play regularly that we love, franchises, didn't feel all that complete and stuff. Obviously, Skylanders Trap Team should be a Game of the Year as far as I'm concerned. As a, I was a big Portal master. I was bummed that Mario Kart beat it out in the family... children's category or casual, whatever he called it on the categories there. But yeah, either, you know, I would have tossed a coin up between Dragon Age and Shadow of Mordor. At least I'd be happy with that. I'm glad to see that GTA 5 somehow wasn't up for Game of the Year again, even though it was like a reissue for the next gen. I thought maybe the
it was in its own category.
Well, yeah, but you know, the suits at work, you know, they sometimes they like to, you know, get those things back in where they shouldn't be. So I was glad that, you know, it didn't resurface again. Also, I should say, I want to wrap up this video in just a second. I should sort of say, I was just kind of, now we're talking about the show. I did like the King's Quest reveal and, like, that whole moment where, you know, they kind of did a tribute to that. And that trailer I thought was really cool. Was there any other, before we wrap this video, any other moments that you kind of remember kind of standing out? Yourself?
Well, I think the I'm trying to look up what the exact name of the award is, but the award that they gave to Ken and Roberta Williams, you know, for starting Sierra, I thought that that was a really nice tribute to a pair of individuals that have contributed so much to video games as a whole, like as an industry and as a culture. And I think that a lot of younger gamers forget, you know, some of the pioneers who really paved the way for games as we know it. So I thought that that was really nice that he gave them a good tribute.
Yeah, yeah, that was all. And that, Roberta, that was the King's Quest and all that. So yeah, mm-hmm. that was really well done. If you survived that long through the show. And then it was cool to see Lindsay Stirling out playing the Dragon Age theme with her violin. And I like that we incorporated some YouTube presence, indie presence in what is considered like a big, even though it was the first one, you know, it kind of gets that Hollywood frame, you know, around it, production. So anything you want to see for, you know, anything else you want to see for next, assuming this will go on next year?
Oh, well, I mean, I hope they bring Reggie back. I think that him doing that Zelda reveal was really, really huge. Like, revealing the first kind of gameplay of the new Wii U for Zelda. And Jeff obviously has a longstanding friendship with Reggie and a lot of the other folks over there at Nintendo. Next year, if it comes back, I would like to just see more awards on stage. I know that they gave some of them out like on the side, and you know, they gave some of them out like beforehand or whatever, but I would just like them to focus a little bit more on the awards and talking about what the awards mean and, you know, why these certain games were picked, what goes into that decision. And obviously, like, it's voted on by a group of people. It's very similar to like the Games Critics Awards at E3. It's, you know, it's a similar group of people that vote on the awards, but yeah, focusing more on the games. I like the reveals, but we didn't need to see all of those reveals because a lot of them weren't new. You know what
yeah.
I mean? I'd say focus on the new stuff. To me, talking more about the same game isn't new. You know, like, we didn't need to see that No Man's Sky footage, right? Like, they easily could have just shown that, and they did the next day at the PlayStation Experience, release a trailer, because people have been talking about that game forever. I would have rather have seen more Zelda or seen, you know, more of something else that was new. That's my only thing. I thought he did a great job, though. If it was the exact same type of show next year, I think it would be just as successful.
Well, cool. Awesome. Well, before I sign out, you viewers at home watching, let us know in the comments below, you know, if you saw the Game Awards, what you thought, what kind of things you may want to see for next year. You know, Jeff Keighley's a big fan of mine. I'm sure he'll read some of these comments and we'll get some of that feedback going. But, Andrea, where's a great place to sort of find you and check out some more of your videos and things like that?
The easiest place is on Twitter, at Andrea Renee, or you can also subscribe to GT News right here on YouTube. That's youtube.com/GT News. That's where my show is on Monday through Friday. It's a daily video game news show. And I also do episodes of Just Play there, so that's those are probably the easiest places to check me out.
Awesome. Well, thanks for jumping on. We're going to do a couple more chatter videos with some other awesome topics. So thanks a bunch for you guys watching, and thanks, Andrea Renee. We'll see you guys next time.